Jetzt bin ich live. Ich bin live. I'm live. Yeah. Some more minutes, then we start. I'm a bit nervous. Ich bin etwas nervös. Yeah, oh, so two people are already here. Zwei Leute sind schon an Bord. Ja, willkommen zurück zu Vita Social News auf unserem Video Social Media Kanal. Welcome back to Vita Social News here on our video social channel. And I will talk in English und ich werde auch in Deutsch sprechen. Wenn Sie Fragen haben, können Sie die natürlich auch in Französisch stellen. Ich versuche die dann zu übersetzen. I will try to translate also other languages like Français, French. We do not know what's happening. I'm a bit nervous. Oh, Flaster is here. So good to see you. Hi. Yeah, so how to start? I would like to start with... some talks I had yesterday on the phone. We had a customer from Cologne. He was asking how to individualize or characterize Vita Enemic, and I was telling him that it is a slightly bit better to use Edge GIL for the workflow, because then you're really making a better surface that the staining and also the other LC flow or other light curing composites will hold on the Vita Enemic. Ja, gestern hatte ich einen Anruf eines Kunden, der hat gefragt, wie er Vita Enemic individualisieren kann, charakterisieren kann. Die Antwort war eigentlich ganz klar. Er hat mich gefragt, ob er Sandstrahlen soll oder ein Edge-Gel verwenden kann oder sollte. Ich habe ihm dazu erklärt, es ist etwas besser, wenn man Edge-Gel benutzt, weil dann die Oberfläche etwas rauer wird und dann auch das ganze Composite bzw. die Malfarbe besser in die Oberfläche eindringt. Das hält dann länger im Gebrauch. Hi, Emet, so Australia is also here. That's really nice. So good to have you here on board. So if, as far as I see, there are no Germans already. So as soon as they will come back, I will also speak German. So if you have questions, please let me know. If not, I will tell you some stories, some jokes maybe. And I have some really good jokes in English. There were some other questions regarding our Vita Bionic Vico system, the new system, a digital denture, which is coming or will be released this summer. How is it working? How is the workflow? We are just at the moment preparing some tutorials with this material, and we'll talk about this later in our web show, in our Vita social media channel this week. Yeah, very good to have you all on board. So if you have questions, again, I will try to answer them. Maybe not all, but some of them, and looking forward to hear from you. Another question was how to prepare the surface of a metal framework, how to prepare the metal framework before you are veneering the metal framework. So the best thing is to follow the rules of your supplier of the metal, of the alloys. We say it's, if you have a cobalt chromium material, that it is the best to sandblast at 250 microns with a 3 bar pressure, and then steam it, and then doing the application of the opaque in two steps. The first step is actually to bring a bit the oxides up, and then the, that we have like oxide bondings between the opaque and the alloys. And then later on the second opaque layer, which is then covering completely the surface of the metal. So kurz nochmal in Deutsch, wie wir vorgehen beim Verblenden von Metall. Metall, gerade bei Kobalt-Chromium oder Stahl, wie der Deutsche sagt, ist es das Beste, wenn man etwas Sand strahlt und dann zwar mit 250 µ, Aluminiumoxid, Edelkorund, und bei etwa 3 bar Druck und dann die Oberfläche schön säubern damit, danach Dampfstrahlen und dann die erste opaker Schicht auftragen. Die erste opaker Schicht ist dazu da, dass sich Oxide bilden und dann über die Oxidbindungen zum opaker praktisch einen perfekten Verbund geben. Und erst der zweite Schritt ist dafür gedacht, dass das Ganze komplett bedeckt ist. Oh, Samir is also here. That's really nice. Good to have you all. As I see that there are only English-speaking people here, so I will speak then English. If not, please stop me and send advice to speak also going back to German. Yeah, maybe you've seen my talk with Marion Baumgartner, our product manager for the pressing material. Our pressing material Vita Ambria is released already in some areas, and we were talking about this material, the steps, and you had a lot of questions like the muffled system, is it the same as we had with the PM9? No, it is not, because the diameter of the ingots is different. So if you use the Vita Ambria kit, you need a muffled system with a diameter for the ingots of 13 millimeter, and then it's the normal pressing workflow you, I think you all know. Yeah, and, Karine, so maintenant je dois parler français, mais I think it's better to talk English. But Karin, if you have questions, please send them in English or in German. Maybe German would be even better for me. Yeah, what were the questions? We had some questions regarding Vita Enamic individualization. I was explaining this already, that you have to, the best way is to use a little bit of etch shield on the surface and then doing the workflow as you are used to do with a light curing composites or the staining materials. Do not use the Vita Accent Plus. It's a ceramic material, and we had also some questions regarding this. Some were using Vita Accent Plus and put the Vita Enamic in the furnace, and I can tell you it was stinking and it became a little bit of white. So yeah, this is not working, that's for sure. So don't use a furnace with Vita Enamic, just for light curing. Yeah, there is a question regarding Vita Ambria. Yes, the question is, can you use Vita Ambria as a framework and then building up the crown with, for example, Vita Lumex AC? Indeed, you can do this, but to be honest, to use the flexural strength of the pressing material, I would stay with, let's say, a very anatomically framework. So don't use a lot of the veneering porcelain, so that you have the power, the strength of the material, and only in some not so forced or not so loaded parts, you can use the Vita Lumex AC as an example. So the Lumex AC, for those who do not know what it is, the Lumex AC is our new veneering porcelain. It's a veneering porcelain for, on the one hand side, zirconia frameworks, and on the other side, it's for the Vita Amplia. Yeah, the Vita Amplia, it's our new pressing material. The good thing is with the Vita Amplia, if you do a second, let's say a second step, it's called a tempering step, you even have a flexural strength of 550 megapascal, which is very good and enough for, yeah, for bridges, especially in the anterior to the second premolar area. Yeah, but I would not. Jenny, a question from Jenny. Thanks. Where is the question? Ah. Okay, why do we use for Vita Amplia only single-use plungers? Look, Jenny, the question is clearly to answer. We had the best results with single-use plungers. We had just not the contamination with the plunger itself. And the thing is, if you use single-use plungers, they are made out of the same material as the investment mask. So you have no differences, no CTE differences, and. So there is not a mismatch between the plunger and the material. That's why we recommend to use single-use plungers. I think if you think about this, it's clear. Yeah. But I know that lots of the users will also have some multiple use plungers, but to be safe, to be more secure, it is better to use a single use plunger. So, are there some more questions? Is it possible to use Accent Plus on Vita Amplia? Yeah, Vita Accent Plus, the good thing about Vita Accent Plus is that you can use it of nearly any ceramic material. You can use it on the metal ceramics, VM15, VM13, VMK Master, and also on the other ceramic materials like zirconia. You can use it on any zirconia. You can use it also on VM7, on VM9, and for sure you can use it also on Vita Lumex AC and on Vita Amplia. So the workflow could be that you only press with the Vita Amplia material, then grind it a little bit, make the texture of the material, and then in the last steps, just staining and glazing. And this is working with the Vita Accent Plus without any doubt and without any problem. Yeah, some. What do you think about sandblasting zirconia frameworks before ceramic layering? That is actually a very good question, Samia. Thanks for this. If we sandblast the surface of the T or the HT zirconia, Vita YZ T or HT material, we have a change to the from tetragonal surface to a monoclinic surface. So we have a change in the crystal structure on the surface, and this is combined with also a slight change in the CTE. This is only on the very thin surface, so it's not going deep into the framework, but on the thin surface, we have this change. We have this change in CTE and crystal structure, and there are some issues with a CTE of 7.7 and the veneering porcelain. That's why we recommend not to do a sandblasting. But to be honest with you, and we are talking here in private, there is no scientific report from clinical cases that there is a problem. But to be sure that there can't be a problem, I would not do a sandblasting. That's why we, as Vita, recommend not to do a sandblasting in the areas where to apply the veneering porcelain. But for bonding to the tools, we recommend a sandblasting in the area where we bond to the tools. with the ST and XT materials, so the super translucent or extra translucent materials, it's slightly different because there we have now cubic crystals and not only tetragonal crystals on the surface. So there is not such a change, also not such a change in the CTE. And this is, from this point of view, it is better. But again, I would not recommend this, so I would not do this. Yeah, I hope I answered your question with this. Yeah, oh, Philippe from France. Bonjour, Philippe. Yeah, this is very interesting and good questions. Yeah, the sandblasting of the zirconia framework, if it's coming out of the sintering furnace, it the surface is very shiny. And it's true that it is not so easy, the build-up, because it doesn't stick as good as a sandblasted surface would be, or on a sandblasted surface it would be. So for this reason, I know that a lot of technicians are sandblasting, but again, I would not recommend this. And there are some other ways. For example, Marcio Preda, he's applying a very wet veneering porcelain, and then he's using some further powder and just stipping it on the surface, and then he has like a mechanical retention on the surface as well. I think this is a very good method to help. So there is a question. Okay, so you want to mean that we decide to use Ambria as a frame, or is it better? Look, it is better when you use it as a frame. Vita, so the question is, Vita Ambria as a frame, would it be better to use a tempering firing before you apply the veneering porcelain? If it is a bridge, I would always suggest to do a tempering firing with the Vita Ambria. Then you are safe. You have a flexural strength of, as I said, from 550 megapascal. So this is far enough for bridges till the second premolar. And then apply the Vita Lumex AC. If you have single crowns, we did, when I was trained as dental technician, we did make them only from veneering porcelain. So I think it will be enough, but to be more safe, to be more secure, tempering firing is better. Yes, that's a point. How is it possible to secure a color match between Vita Ambria and Zirconia? I think Empire. I think it's Ambria. Look, the Vita Zirconia and the Vita Ambria is matching the Vita Classical shades, so there is no problem to match them. The only thing is the light transmission and the light reflection is different in zirconia and in ambria. So to match it better, to have a more light effect, I would always apply even a thin layer of Vita Lumex AC or VN9. I would apply this, and then it is more easy to match. But you will match the shade, but not the shine for your eyes for the of the materials, because zirconia looks always slightly different than ambria. I hope this answers your question as well. Omar, I hope you understand what I mean. Materials are looking different in the light, looking different in the oral environment. even if they are matching the same shade, the same color, to get rid of such a problem, it's always better to use a material which is the same. So I would go with a veneering porcelain, and then even for the eye, even for the light transmission, even for this, they are looking the same. But the color itself, if you only look on the color, you do not need porcelain. I hope this is helping you. Yeah, very good. So, okay. How about the thickness of the Vita Umbria if you use it as a frame? Very good question. Very good question. The thickness of the Vita Umbria for single crowns. As I said, we were using veneering porcelain without a framework. So the thickness there, okay, we have in our instruction the thickness written. It has to be 1 millimeter thick, but for single use in the anterior area, I know that sometimes in some cases, if there is not such a big load from the antagonist, you can be slightly thinner, but I would stay as thick as possible. I hope this is helping you. All the numbers or all the thicknesses we are having in our instructions are tested in lots of chewing simulation systems, lots of testing cycles, and that's why we have such thicknesses. But everything is depending on the individual patient, on the individual situation. So I would go always as thick as possible with the framework material. That's the advice I can give to you. So, okay. So I drink something. Yeah. Ah, there was a question from a colleague of you guys. What is when you use monolithic zirconia, so no veneering at all, so monolithic zirconia, and you have a problem with contact points? So, for example, some of your colleagues here in Germany are doing like this. They are minimizing actually the contact points from the zirconia, and they apply either veneering porcelain on these points or some thicker staining material. Why? Because then the dentist can, if they do the occlusal adjustments, they can easier polish this in the mouth again, so that they have always a smooth surface. And in the areas where the contacts are, it is far more easy to get rid of the material, to grind the material, and then to repolish it. So that's why they apply their porcelain with the CTE, for example, the Vita Lumex AC or the Vita VM9, and just in the contact points, and then they can easy adjust this and easy polish this into a high shine. Another thing is also if you have the, especially the contact areas in a veneering porcelain, the feeling for the patient, the feeling for the patients is more natural. We have some studies done with our Vita Blox material, and there we have studies with them for 15 years in the mouth, and the abrasion and everything was very much the same as the natural tooth. So that's why the abrasion is more or less the same as a natural tooth, and so the patient has no issues with, let's say, with this pure zirconia. So just a thin layer of veneering or a thicker layer of staining and glaze material is the best in the contact areas. And if you need more contact, it's also easy to apply porcelain or staining material. I hope this is helping.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you have more questions, please let me know. This is very interesting to me. Very good questions already. I think we should do this again. Question regarding the regeneration firing. Is it a must? Regeneration firing means if you sandblast the surface of zirconia and you have the change from tetragonal into monolithic and on the surface, we recommend to do regeneration firing. Look, it's more or less the same answer as before. If you sandblast, you have this change from tetragonal to monolithic. Monoclinic, sorry. The words are for me nearly the same, so that's why. So tetragonal to monoclinic crystal structure. If you do a regeneration firing, you have again the tetragonal surface. So you come back to the same situation as before the sandblasting. You can do this at 1000 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes and then apply the veneering porcelain. We recommend this because I said this before, if you do the sandblasting, the changes is also involved the CTE, a coefficient of thermal expansion differences. So we have now a lower coefficient, and then there are some tensions between the zirconia and the veneering porcelain. That's why we recommend this. But again, there is no scientific research going on this topic saying you need this, that this is a must. We recommend this to be sure, to be more secure when you apply the veneering porcelain, but there is no research telling us that this is a must. But I would do it if there is a chance. What is the difference between using the system coating when injecting Ampere compared to another coating? Between using the system coating when injecting. I do not understand this question. Maybe you can explain it to me. So I go to the next question with thickness. Which thickness is optimal for Lumex on zirconia? Look, the thickness can be very thin. You need, you can do up to 0.2 millimeter thickness of Lumex. Why 0.2 millimeter? Then you have for sure the same fluorescence of the veneering porcelain as you have if you would do fully veneered zirconia coping. So 0.2, 0.15, maybe it's also enough, then you receive fluorescence like you would have if you would do a complete covering or complete veneering of a zirconia coping. That's the point why the thickness is. If not, you can apply it very thin and it will stay on the surface of the zirconia without a problem, but to have a perfect fluorescence, to have a fluorescence as we know from natural teeth, it is better to apply slightly more, so 0.15. I hope this helps. I do not understand, sorry. Yeah, the Vita Ampria, maybe this is the question, how to use or which pressing system is the best. Of course, the one with the Vita furnace, but the others are working as well. So we think that we have a very good furnace and a very good pressing method. But the other furnaces are also working, and the result of the Ampria will be the same in the other furnaces. I'm sure if you follow the rules, if you follow the steps of the pressing and the pressing methods, then you will have and receive a perfect result with other pressing systems. And maybe this was your question. I'm not completely sure. Yeah, this was it for today. I hope you come back. I think this was a challenging thing for me, and I was a bit thrilling. I was sweating, and I had a really good time with you guys, and thanks a lot. And I hope I see you again here, and see you again here on Facebook. If you like to, or if you have more questions, write an email to info@vita-zahnfabrik.com. And my colleagues and me personally, we will answer your questions as soon as possible. And I hope when we do this again next week, I see you again and have a good evening. Oh, there's another question. Oh, thanks. One more question. How can the different shade guides be sterilized? There are some differences in between them, but the Vita can be sterilized. This is working, but not in the box. Please do not use the linear guide completely in the box. Do not put them completely in the sterilization. It will not work, but the sticks, they will work. Ah, the taps. Ah, thanks. Thanks. My colleague just mentioned that the taps, the Vita shade guides, are made out of ceramic material. So ceramic material, they are really ceramic material, not polymer. They have no problems with light. They have no problems with other issues. So because they are made out of ceramic, you can sterilize them, you can steam them. There is no problem and not changing color or things like this. Maybe this was the question, as far as I see. New comments? Ah, look, now you wake up, guys. temp for bonding on zirconia. Look, the point is temporary bonding with zirconia. It is possible, yes, it is possible, but the problem is if they are veneered and they are just temporary bonded, the temporary bond is not as good as the full bonding or the full adhesive system. So if it's a bit shaking, a bit warping, and then there can be a problem with the veneering. So if you do a full monolithic zirconia, you can temporary bond this, no problem. But if you have a veneering on top, I would not do this because the bond is not as good, as I said, and then it can chip because some interactions in the mouth. Yeah. This, can I veneer Lumix on other materials? Yes, Maurice from LA. Maurice from LA. Cool that you are here. Maurice, yes, you can use Vita Lumix AC on Vita Amplia and on every zirconia material. For example, the Vita YZT, the Vita YZHT, the Vita YZST, and the Vita YZHT is possible. And you can veneer easily the Vita Lumix AC on these different framework materials. So it's very bright. It's a low temperature or low fusing material, so you have lots of chances. Not only on Amprea, you can use it also on the blue block from Liechtenstein. I forgot the name of the company, but you maybe know. So thanks again. And how long can we use the shade guide for? You can use the shade guide forever. So I've seen some really old shade guides from the classical shade guides, which are in use for 30 years and still in use and still working. And the thing is that the box or the thing where the sticks are in, this is a polymer, and there we have some changes during the years, but not on the shade tips, not on the on the tooth or on the teeth of the shared guide. Yeah, so you can use it for a very long time, a very long time. But means, should I not put the whole shared guide in this? Yeah, look, we had some in my area. The question was, can I do not the whole shared guide in the sterilization machine? That's a good point. In my area, there is the complaints. We get also the complaints from you guys. We get also the complaints, and we are checking and testing the complaints. And there were some issues with the box of the linear guides. So the whole box, they put not a shade tab in the sterilization, they put the whole box in the sterilization. And the box, the sterilization and the autoclaving systems have a too high temperature for the whole box. That this is what I meant with don't put all together in. Just the tabs, it's okay, no problem. But the whole box, it is a problem. It can be a problem. Forgot the name of the device. Okay, so come back, and I'm looking forward, as I said, info@vita-sanfabrik.com. Looking forward to your questions, and we will do this again next week, maybe on the Wednesday, we will see. And yeah, thanks again for this. As I said, it was thrilling for me, but I had a good time, and thanks for the questions, very interesting, and I hope we have you back. Goodbye, stay healthy, and yeah, see you next time. Bye.